And fire is a big problem throughout the metro today as folks are just trying to keep warm with these bitter cold temperatures. Our crews were on the scene as firefighters kept the flames at bay. News 4's Cassandra Sweetman has the details tonight. Cassandra.
Abby, the cold weather can make these fires difficult to battle and simply more frequent.
Several
I'm so
calls,
sorry I didn't like
fire calls here in the past.
Crews called to what used to be a Catholic school, now vacant and poorly boarded up.
I believe we had possible transients that have come in and trying to warm themselves in this cold weather, and it caught some trash on fire. That's what it appears to be this time. That's what we've had in the past.
They're still investigating, but that's not uncommon when the temperature drops. Luckily, no one was found inside, injured or otherwise. The fire didn't overtake the building.
This is just a small portion in the back of the structure, a small area that basically been on fire before.
But an earlier house fire was much more destructive.
The first crew that arrived on scene found heavy smoke coming from this house.
No one inside, another vacant structure.
No one living here, no power to this structure. So we're still a little bit unsure as to why it started.
But crews did run into obstacles extinguishing the flames.
We had some difficulties with floor furnace. One of the firefighters kind of got his foot hung up in the floor furnace, and once that happened, at the same time, the fire continued to progress.
The fire too dangerous to fight on the inside.
We went ahead and pulled everybody out, went defensive, and then tried to get a knockdown on the fire from the exterior.
Not easy when, like the metro roads, the driveway is covered in ice as more water freezes in the hoses and on the outside of gear.
Then have to rotate some of our crews, relieve them so that they have a chance to rest.
Now firefighters reminding people to keep empty property boarded up to prevent fires like this in the future.
We have different areas around the city where transients can go, especially in this cold weather. They open up, especially during this time.
Now firefighters are also reminding people they're checking and installing smoke alarms, equipment they insist can be a light.